G'day viewers, welcome to Wazahar's Triple Eight. This thing here is a reason why I don't normally put my face on, because it's not a good looking thing. It's about as good as it gets. Unless I go out on a big night out and then it looks something like this. Apparently the face I've got is only one that a mother can love, which is a bit of a shame because we lost Mum a few years ago. Well, we know where she is, but she's passed on, so. But anyway, what we're doing today, I'm going to do a bit of unboxing, unpacking, and I'll try not to say the word as much as I already am. Bought some stuff on eBay. What did I get? I got a 1080p camera, not a GoPro, not a GoPro clone, but a GoPro clone of a clone. So we'll see how that goes. Not expecting too much, cost me about $25. Also bought a GoPro frame, that was fairly cheap, and a external microphone. Now this is all to go with doing the videos, doing a bit of motor vlogging, and bits and pieces. But anyway, that's enough waffling on. Welcome to Wazahar's Triple Eight, and enjoy the video. Like and subscribe, and we'll catch you soon. All right, well, we'll try that again. I don't know what the sound's like. The GoPro's inside the waterproof housing with the skeleton back on it. This is why I bought some stuff off eBay, so I can increase the quality of fraction. Not a millionaire, don't have $1 million to spend, just do everything on the cheap. But anyway, here we go. Came in the post today. First item, first cab off the rank. Let's see what we got. We'll open them up. Sports cam, wonderful packaging. Look, I know there's a million and one videos out there, but I just want to do something with this anyway. Let's have a look, see what's inside, see what comes up with. Not a great deal, empty packet. Here's the camera. Not a lot to look at. Much the same as the thing that's filming this, by looks. Obviously not in quality. So put that aside. Accessories. Little tripod adapter mount, which is for a frame, which is in there, I believe. Sticky pad or screw. Charging cable. Handlebar mount. Another angle bracket, come in handy. Another mount. Velcro bits and pieces. And a user manual. Look, even if this thing doesn't work, I mean, it's cost me $25. Not bad value. Hang on, I keep moving the shot. Let's bring in the shot here. Bring that down here. All the way there. And the camera. So, to buy these accessories for the other camera, for the GoPro, it cost me $25 anyway, or more. And you get a cheap ass camera that goes with it. So, let's just unbox it, unpack it, and see what comes out of here.
easier said than done. Let's see. There we go. Adult proof. Nice tight fit, which is good. It's very light. Lightweight. And it's not a name brand or anything like that. The lighting is shocking, sorry about that. But look, that is what it is. Let's turn him on. And we've got nothing because the battery's flat, so absolutely nothing. That's cool. What I might do is go and put some charge in it and I'll come back. Alrighty, well, we've got this little fella. And we got this stuff. Then we got this thing. Then we got that. Then we got that. So let's turn it on. See what happens. Nothing. I have put a bit of charge in. Not much. Oh, there we go. It does work. Very exciting. Yeah, look, these can be used as a dash cam as well, apparently. So it's got date, time and stuff on it, which I'm going to have to work out how to get rid of down the track. At the moment, it's set up for video and media. Anyway, look, this is going to take some getting used to. It's a good little camera for $25. What I might do is shoot some footage with it and see how it goes. Cup of coffee, don't mind if I do. Obviously a present for one of the kids. Let's see what we've got in this box, in the bag. Yep. It's a not so strong little thing, but anyway, doesn't matter. That. Look, I might only use this once and the thing might fall off. I don't know. I don't care. It's just a good little thing to play with. Give me another option, maybe. I'm going to clip this on. Clip this on my chest mount. And there's my GoPro on the handlebars. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. That feels cool. Little base plate, the screwy thing. Which that screws into there. It goes on like so. I can put it on a tripod. Have I got a tripod? I might have a little tripod here. Give me 2 seconds. It's in my bedroom, but that's all right. That's cool. So that will fit under there. Like a saw. Oh, cool. first opened this, I thought, geez, that doesn't look too good, that lens. It's a bit hazy. Then I realised it's got a protective covering on it. Oh, look at that. Clear as. Alright, what have we got here? Oh yeah, just an angle dead end doohickey. So that can go into there. And we can change that to there, so we can change angles. Same as it goes there. And Velcro faster. Which would loop around here, I presume. So yeah, look, we'll have a play with all this and see how it goes. Anyway, back soon. Yeah, like a clever little fella. I thought I was recording when I wasn't. Anyway, we're recording now. What I was going to show you was this thing here. This is my microphone for my helmet. It was a set of iPhone headphones. Cut the earplugs off here. You see the plus and minus zone, which was there for volume control for your headphones. Doesn't work now, but this little bit in the middle is a microphone. Bit of Velcro on the back. Loves your uncle. And when I first put it in, I had the microphone too close to my mouth, and it sounded like I was heavy breathing. Probably was, I'm grossly unfit, as you can tell. But in the last video, I moved it down a little bit, and it seemed to be a lot better quality. So hopefully that's made a big difference. And when I get the rest of the stuff that's coming, there'll be the frame and a microphone adapter to go into the GoPro. So things will be a lot better. So anyway, that's what I wanted to show you there. And back soon.
All right, that's it. Going to sign off now. Thanks for being patient. Thanks for putting that with me. Yes, the face isn't good, but that's all. It's as good as it's going to get. It's not going to get any better. I'll try and do some lightheaded stuff once I get the hang of doing this face thing with the video. Not something I ever started out planning doing. I just wanted to video some rides, but you know, that can get a bit boring after a while. So we've got a few things coming up. I've got a 1972 Victor utility lawnmower that a mate gave to me, a pod guy I used to work with. He said it wasn't running, but he said, look, here, you can have it. So I brought it home, stripped the cover down, cleaned the spark plug, put some clean fuel in it, fired it up, and it works a treat. Another project I've got is another guy from work gave me a Triton Work Center Mark III in a pretty sad state. He bought it some years ago for a project that he did. He bought it second hand, and it was just left. So the paint's all peeling off and whatever and whatever. So I'll, over a period of time when I've got a bit more room in the garage, I'm actually operating out of a garage, not a shed. We are getting a shed built down the track, but when I get a bit more room in here, move the barbecue out, set the shelving up a little better, then I've got a bit of room to play around with and do some projects. So long-term things, we'll see how we go. As I said, just the main bit of fun, so I can do a bit of vlogging on the bike and waffle on and talk about garbage, and hopefully I'll get some likes and subscribes. That'll be good, because it'll be nice to give up my day job and do this full time. Yeah, right. Sick of dealing with the public. It's getting close to Christmas and everyone is losing their freaking minds. So anyway, on that note, we'll sign off. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Catch you next time. Thanks.